Hello all, this is Universal Group of Institutions, Bangalore. India's semiconductor industry has been gaining attention due to its critical role in technology-driven sectors, which would be electronics, telecommunication, automotive, as well as IT. Here's an overview of the current landscape and initiatives that's shaping the semiconductor industry that's growing in India. Growth drivers. So increasing demand for electronics, which is India is one of the largest consumers for electronic goods. The demand for smartphones, computers, automotive, electronics, and all the other smart devices has fueled the need for semiconductor components. Digital India initiative. So the government has programs like Digital India, Made in India. All of these have been prioritized. Domestic semiconductor manufacturing, attracting investment as well as partnerships. Automotive industry. So the growing electric vehicle market in India is pushing the need for more sophisticated semiconductor technology, which is mainly going to be the sensors as well as the power electronics. Then comes the telecom and the 5G. The rollout of 5G technology in India is expected to increase the demand for advanced semiconductor components and also useful for communication as well as infrastructure. Next, moving on to the government initiatives. The Indian government is focusing heavily on promoting semiconductor manufacturing as well as research and development through various policies. So starting off with the first scheme, which is mainly going to be your PLI scheme, which is Production Linked Incentive. So this scheme offers financial incentives to all the companies that manufacture semiconductors in India. It is aimed at building a robust electronic manufacturing ecosystem, which includes semiconductor fabs, that is fabrication units. Next comes SPECS. So what exactly is this SPECS? It is a scheme for promotion of manufacturing of electronic components and semiconductors. This initiative provides financial incentives for investment in electronic components, semiconductors, and other key technology areas. Moving on to the India Semiconductor Mission, which is ISM. So this was launched in the year 2022. ISM is a dedicated initiative to support the semiconductor ecosystem through the financial as well as policy measures. The mission focuses on attracting global players to set up semiconductor fabs in India.
मैंने इस साल लाल किले से कहा है, हमारा सपना है कि दुनिया की हर डिवाइस में इंडियन मेड चिप हो। सेमीकंडक्टर पावर हाउस बनने के लिए जो भी जरूरी होगा भारत वो सब करने वाला है। साथियों, क्रिटिकल मिनरल्स के डोमेस्टिक प्रोडक्शन और इसके ओवरसीज एक्विजिशन के लिए हमने कुछ समय पहले क्रिटिकल मिनरल मिशन की घोषणा की। क्रिटिकल मिनरल्स को कस्टम्स ड्यूटी से छूट देना हो, क्रिटिकल मिनरल्स को ब्लॉक्स की माइनिंग की ऑक्शन हो, इन सब पर तेजी से काम हो रहा है। और सिर्फ इतना ही नहीं है, हम इंडियन इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ स्पेस साइंस में एक सेमीकंडक्टर रिसर्च सेंटर बनाने के लिए भी काम कर रहे हैं। हम IITs के साथ पार्टनरशिप कर रहे हैं ताकि हमारे इंजीनियर ना सिर्फ अभी के लिए हाईटेक चिप बनाए बल्कि नेक्स्ट जेन चिप पर भी रिसर्च करें। हम इंटरनेशनल कोलैबोरेशन को भी आगे बढ़ा रहे हैं। आप लोगों ने ऑयल डिप्लोमेसी का नाम सुना है। आज का युग सिलिकॉन डिप्लोमेसी का युग है। इसी साल भारत इंडो पैसिफिक इकोनॉमिक फ्रेमवर्क की सप्लाई चेन काउंसिल का वाइस चेयर चुन गया है। हम क्वाड सेमीकंडक्टर सप्लाई चेन इनिशिएटिव के भी बड़े पार्टनर हैं और हाल ही में हमने जापान और सिंगापुर समेत कई देशों के साथ एग्रीमेंट भी साइन किए। इस सेक्टर में अमेरिका के साथ भी भारत अपना सहयोग लगातार बढ़ा रहा। साथियों, आप सभी भारत के सेमीकंडक्टर मिशन को भी जानते हैं। कुछ लोग सवाल भी उठाते हैं कि भारत इस पर फोकस क्यों कर रहा है। ऐसे लोगों को हमारे डिजिटल इंडिया मिशन को जरूर स्टडी करना चाहिए। डिजिटल इंडिया मिशन का लक्ष्य देश को एक ट्रांसपेरेंट, इफेक्टिव और लीकेज फ्री गवर्नेंस देना था और आज हम इसके मल्टीप्लायर इफेक्ट को अनुभव कर रहे हैं। डिजिटल इंडिया की सफलता के लिए हमें अफोर्डेबल मोबाइल हैंडसेट और डेटा की जरूरत थी। इसके लिए हमने जरूरी रिफॉर्म्स और जरूरी इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर बनाया। एक दशक पहले हम मोबाइल फोन के बड़े इंपोर्टर्स में से एक थे। आज हम दुनिया के नंबर टू प्रोड्यूसर और एक्सपोर्टर हैं। अभी एक ताजा रिपोर्ट आई है, आज भारत 5G हैंडसेट का दूसरा सबसे बड़ा मार्केट बन चुका है। दो साल पहले ही हमने 5G रोल आउट शुरू किया था। आज देखिए हम कहां से कहां पहुंच चुके हैं। आज भारत का इलेक्ट्रॉनिक सेक्टर $150 बिलियन से भी ज्यादा का हो चुका है और अब तो हमारा लक्ष्य और बड़ा है। इस दशक के अंत तक हम अपने इलेक्ट्रॉनिक सेक्टर को $500 बिलियन तक पहुंचाना चाहते हैं। इससे भारत के युवाओं के लिए करीब 6 मिलियन यानी 60 लाख जॉब क्रिएट होगी। भारत के सेमीकंडक्टर सेक्टर को भी इसका बहुत अधिक फायदा होगा। हमारा लक्ष्य है कि इलेक्ट्रॉनिक मैन्युफैक्चरिंग का 100% काम भारत में ही हो, यानी भारत सेमीकंडक्टर चिप्स भी बनाएगा और उनके फिनिश गुड्स भी बनाएगा।
मूविंग ऑन टू द नेक्स्ट वन व्हिच इज मेनली गोइंग टू बी द मेजर प्लेयर्स। सो ऑल्दो इंडिया डज नॉट हैव लार्ज स्केल डोमेस्टिक सेमीकंडक्टर मैन्युफैक्चरिंग, सेवरल मल्टीनेशनल कंपनीज हैव सेट अप रिसर्च, डिजाइन एज वेल एज डेवलपमेंट सेंटर। Intel, which is a major player with a significant research and development present in India, especially in Bangalore. Then you have Texas Instruments, one of the finest first semiconductor companies to set up a research as well as development center in India, focusing on design as well as software solutions. We have another technology, which is mainly the Micron technology, which sets up operations in India with a focus on memory as well as storage solution. Then we have the Tata Group, recently announced plans to enter the semiconductor business, starting off with the chip packaging as well as testing facilities. Moving on to the challenges that we're going to face, lack of fabrication plants, which is your fabs. So despite this huge, wonderable progress that India has made in the semiconductor design as well as research and development, the country currently lacks large-scale semiconductor fabrication units. So fabs require significant capital investment as well as advanced technology. Then we have the supply chain. Semiconductor supply chain is a complex and requires components from lot and variety of industries over there. Chemicals, or for that matter, the rare materials, all of this. And with this aspect, India is still developing. Then we have the skilled workforce. While India has a strong pool of software engineers, but the country needs more expertise in hardware design as well as semiconductor specific skills. And when we look at the capital, it's definitely a high capital investment that we can have a look at. So semiconductor manufacturing, this entire sector that you see, it's capital intensive. Building a state-of-the-art fabrication plant, it can cost billions and billions of dollars. India lacks the substantial upfront investment which is needed to compete with already established global players. Competition is definitely going to be there from all the global giants. Okay, so it is going to face competition from already established semiconductor manufacturing hubs, which comes from your Taiwan, from your South Korea, US, China. All of them have already had a considerable head start. It could be with respect to manufacturing capacity or, you know, the technological expertise that you need, everything. Infrastructure and utility issues. So semiconductor fabs require uninterrupted power supply, pure water, stable industrial environment. India's infrastructure, especially in regions with potential to host fabs, may not be sufficient when it comes to reliability or the quality of the semiconductor manufacturing. Then we have the recent development, which is the Vedanta Foxconn JV. So in 2022, we have Vedanta as well as Foxconn. They together have announced a joint venture that they are going to set up a semiconductor manufacturing plant in India, which marks a major step towards building the country's first large-scale semiconductor. Global semiconductor shortage. The global chip shortage has underscored the need for India to invest in domestic manufacturing. As there will be a lot of disruption that you'll see in the supply chain, all of this will affect a lot of industry, which could be the automotive or the consumer electronics. How do we have a look at the future? So self-reliance on semiconductors. So India mainly aims to reduce the dependence on imports by boosting its own manufacturing. You know, they want to try and manufacture their own semiconductor. They want to improve their capability. Government, private sector, both of them are going to have a collaboration. This will be definitely necessary. It's very crucial. So the government and the private sector has to come together. Then we have the export potential. So with the right infrastructure, India can emerge as a global hub for semiconductor design, semiconductor manufacturing, and it can also start to, you know, catering to both the domestic as well as the international markets.